Hello, and welcome to part one of our Mastering Keyword Searching series. In this tutorial, I'll explain what keyword searching is, how to identify keywords from your own topic, and how to build a list of keywords to get ready for database searching. First, what is keyword searching? When you're doing a keyword search in most library databases, you're researching the titles, abstracts, and citation information of all of the articles in that database. For the most part, you aren't searching full text, which can be a real blessing for not getting overwhelmed by an enormous results list. The biggest challenge when it comes to keyword searching is matching the words you use in your search to the words authors use in their articles. Before we can get to searching, however, we need to formulate a question. One model for doing this is PICO, where each of the letters in the acronym stand for an element of your question. Why do we use PICO? It helps us to get a question that is specific enough to be answered. It also translates beautifully into the beginnings of a search strategy. The issue you're exploring, intervention, diagnostic tool, etiology, etc., will determine the type of PICO question you ask. These are some templates you can use. The important thing about knowing the type of question you're asking is that it leads you to knowing the type of research you need. When you're asking a question about interventions, you need to look for intervention studies. Although it may seem obvious now when I'm saying it, that point can get lost when you're in the thick of your literature search. So how do we use PICO questions? Well, it can be a chicken and egg situation. Sometimes you start by identifying your PICO elements and then turning it into a question. Sometimes you start with a question and map the terms to the PICO elements. Either way is fine. In this example, we'll start with a question. Let's say you've come up with this question. At a glance, I can tell it includes the PICO elements. However, there is one problem in this form. It is very specific to the project or research you want to conduct. But it is far too specific for a database search and probably won't get you the kind of evidence you need for your literature review. We want to use language that will help us find all of the articles that are related to this topic. So we need to broaden the ideas a bit. Let's see what that might look like. Does participation in peer support groups prevent compassion fatigue in health professionals? You'll remember that the question originally referred to balance groups, but we may also want to see studies that are about other forms of peer support. Similarly, we broaden from physical therapists to health professionals, because chances are that if an intervention works for nurses, physicians, etc., it may also work for physical therapists, and there is a lot more research done about physicians and nurses than there is about physical therapists. Now let's identify our PICO elements. You can see them highlighted here. Next, let's match them up. Our population is health professionals, our intervention is peer support, and our outcome is reduced compassion fatigue, but uh-oh, we don't have a comparison. Panic! No, don't be silly. This is fine because we really do have a comparison. We'll be comparing people who participate in peer support to people who receive no intervention at all. In fact, even when you do have a comparison, it isn't unusual to leave the comparison out of the keyword search. Sometimes it can be just too limiting, and we need to prioritize other elements. Of course, you may not know which elements to prioritize until you've tried some test searches to see what comes up. We'll get there, and then talk about prioritizing in the video about revising your search. Next, let's start using these terms to create a search strategy. Naturally, we in the library like to keep everything organized. Just kidding, you should see my desk. However, in this case, I actually do. I use a table like this one to help me. And what we'll do is start to brainstorm synonyms or alternative terms. You might be asking yourself, but why can't we just use the terms we have and get to the searching already? You certainly could, but your search won't be as good without this brainstorming. If you remember at the beginning of this video, I said the biggest challenge when it comes to keyword searching is matching the words you use in your search to the words authors use in their articles. The words that authors use can have a lot of variation, and we need to account for that. For example, health professional. Some authors might use that term, but many more will be looking at particular populations, just like we had planned in the original research question. So if we want articles about other health professions, we need to name those professions in our search. Physical therapists, nurses, physicians, occupational therapists, physician assistants, speech-language pathologists, genetic counselors, etc. And you'll notice I've used some shorthand abbreviations for the professions. Here, in my own notes, that's fine, but do remember you'll need to type out the entire phrase when we translate these terms over to the databases. Okay, now we need to do that same brainstorming for the other terms as well. One of the things I like about this process is that it can help you think about what fits and what doesn't. For example, are compassion fatigue and burnout similar enough for our topic? Is occupational stress too broad? Often, you won't know the answers to these questions until you run some searches. Speaking of which, you may also not know all the alternative terminology until you run some searches, but I'll talk more about that in the Refining Your Search video as well. One last note about brainstorming keywords. Remember to include international variations as well as variations on spelling or format. Even these small variations need to be considered in your search. The other reason I like using a table like this is because it helps me organize my search as well and identify where my ands and ors should be. As the arrows indicate, you or together the terms within the columns and you and together the terms across the columns. So that does it for the essentials of keyword searching. I began to hint about using and or in the previous slide. For more on that, head to the Putting Your Keywords Together video that's next up in the series. It will teach you about and, or, and several other tricks for successful database searching. See you there.